The winner is Cindy.
In a few days' time, the eyes of the world will focus on Sydney Harbour as it comes to life at the start of the Olympics. The flame lit in Olympia in Greece will have been carried around the world and across this famous bridge, symbolising the spirit of unity and sportsmanship, which is right at the very heart of these games. And so we too have come to Sydney for a special Olympic Songs of Praise. Where else could our programme Songs of Praise come from this evening except right here at the Sydney Opera House, probably the most familiar landmark on this beautiful harbour. And we have a terrific evening of music lined up for you with the help of the Opera Australia Orchestra and their leader, Yinlin Pan, and one of our favourite conductors from the UK, Noel Tredinnick, and a great audience of 2,500 Christians all raring to go with our first hymn, All People That on Earth Do Dwell. Over 7 years in preparation, the road to the Olympic Games is long and hard. But there is another road that leads from Olympia to Sydney, and it's one that's rich in spirit. 10,000 torchbearers who are champions in their own communities will have carried the Olympic flame across Australia. This is the longest torch relay in history, and one that has focused the hopes and dreams of people from around the world.
For me, the torch represents hope and vision, and the fact that it's spreading that hope and vision to communities throughout Australia is just tremendous, I think, and it's nice to be part of that. And if we can focus on the unity and hope and celebration of the Olympics for a couple of weeks, then surely we can carry that on throughout our lives.
Possibly goes a little bit deeper than just the spirit of the torch. By bringing people together and so forth, maybe, you know, the Holy Spirit is involved to bring people and nations together. And I would hope that that is a thing. I believe the more we unite together, the greater understanding we'll have for one another.
I see the flame as the flame of God's love, and I see that being carried right around the world to unite us. I'm Anne-Marie Jensen. I'm a presentation sister, fondly known out here in the West as the Flying Nun.
Here we are in Longreach at the moment, and my area goes right down here into the New South Wales border, and all of this area over here to the South Australian border, and then over here to the Northern Territory border. So that takes in 280,000 square kilometres.
Good gracious.
Larger than the whole of Great Britain itself. I'd probably have about 1,000 people in this area, and I think Great Britain about 50...
Million-ish?
50 million, yes.
1,000 people. So, I mean, you could go for hours and hours and not see a house at all, couldn't you?
You could.
What is the aim of your ministry?
I would say pastoral care of families who are geographically isolated, just being a friend and a sounding board for the families.
Now, what sort of life will these families be living?
They're mainly sheep and cattle properties in the southwest corner. Over the 10 years that I've been flying, most of them have been through drought time, so it's been very tough times.
We just wait for Anne-Marie to come around and save it all up for her and sort of burn her ears off. I think she's got the biggest set of shoulders of anyone out here at the moment. She sort of listens to all our problems and whinges, and everyone feels happier once they've had a little whinge to somebody. Anne-Marie, she's always there for us.
And help us to grow as your people towards the fullness of eternal life with you.
I'm with them in their sacred moments. I'm with them from birth. I was present when one of the mums had a baby. And I've been with them in their death too. And then all in between. My prayer is like having a conversation with God, and it's usually a conversation with who I've just been with the families, just to sort of talk over. It's like a debriefing with a friend to say, what I've been concerned about or what are worries, and then I just leave it with my companion God, and then as I fly along, just looking at this beautiful world that I fly over, and then preparing myself to who am I going to meet next. So it's just a conversation with God.
You never have a set day for church, and all of a sudden a nun's there. She just drops in, she just churches and flows off again.
Our Father Jeff isn't able to be with us, but we gather, and we know that where two or three are gathered in my name, Jesus is here present.
You know, I'm very proud of my own tradition. I grew up in the Catholic tradition, regular mass going. Then all of a sudden, here I am exposed to other people who had a whole different background to me, and so yes, I think they invited me to come and experience our way of life, how we meet our God, and that has broadened me. And I know when the Olympics actually happens, that they know that we've been one little part in this journey, a small part, but the most important part. Our sisters first came to Longreach on the 13th of February 1900, so for 100 years we've been here carrying the flame of God's love.
Well, the city of Sydney heard that it was successful in its bid to host the Olympics about 7 years ago, and someone who knows all about that, because he was involved in putting that bid together, is Bruce Baer, the federal minister. I wonder, Bruce, about what sort of opportunity you think that this presents to the city of Sydney.
Well, it provides us an opportunity to show the 4 billion people that will watch the Olympics worldwide what a wonderful and magnificent city that we really have. And more than that, it provides us with an opportunity to share the gospel of Jesus Christ also to the people of the world.
Well, let's bring in Peter King here, because I know you're very involved with an organisation which is interdenominational called Quest More Than Gold. Now, what's all that about?
Well, that's an umbrella organisation that's bringing all the denominations together to extend a great Christian welcome to the peoples of the world and to present to them a Christian message once they get here. And it's to get people excited about the Olympics and to do something. And this is a great opportunity for Australia and particularly for the city of Sydney.
And the Sydney Christians are right behind this, that's quite clear.
Absolutely. I mean, you see how many we've got here tonight. And I believe the Christians in Sydney have seen the vision. The ball has been passed to us and we don't mean to mess up. It'll be a great opportunity.
Well, thank you both very much indeed. Well, of course, the opening of the Olympics in a few days' time is the culmination of a vast amount of planning and preparation by so many people.
Sydney itself has been undergoing major refurbishment in preparation for the Olympics. Tagged the Green Games, nearly £1.5 billion has been spent to transform the once neglected Homebush Bay area into a world-class sporting metropolis. The Christian community is also counting down to the Olympics.
The Olympics is a fantastic opportunity to show the whole world that there's more to life than gold medals. And for us as a Christian community in Sydney, we're trying to show that that thing is a relationship with Jesus Christ.
Special Olympic edition Bibles have been printed featuring Christian Olympian stories, and around 80 different sports outreach events have been planned.
We're hoping that we can impact somewhere between 3,000 and 4,000 young people through the More Than Gold sports outreach.
Hundreds of Christian musicians from across Australia will be travelling to Sydney to perform for athletes and visitors during the Olympic Games. Melbourne band River Tribe are travelling up for the event.
The eyes are on Australia here, and I think it's time for the Christians to stand up and, you know, be counted at a time when we're likely to be noticed. I think that it's most important that Christ is represented properly during the Olympics.
With so many visitors expected, hotel prices will be high and beds scarce. Windsor Baptist Church realised there might be a potential problem for the thousands of volunteers expected, and so are transforming their rural church into a tent city for 4,000.
Our vision here is to provide accommodation, food and transport for young Christians to share in the Olympic spirit and to share their faith within Sydney.
I'm hoping that the churches in Sydney will make effective connection with the community at large, that the tourists coming will see something different about the Sydney Olympics, that the athletes will see something different too, and that they'll put that difference down to Jesus Christ.
Olympic venues have been host to moments of anticipation and joy even before the games have started.
Do you believe in the Holy Catholic Church?
Earlier this year, the new Olympic Superdome was host to a series of unique mass confirmation ceremonies for parishes across Sydney.
Body and life everlasting.
Celebrations have also taken place here at Homebush Bay, with the plan that some of these festival activities will be mirrored in communities around Australia during the Olympic Games themselves. School children have filled the 100,000 seats of the main Olympic Stadium to launch the Catholic Jubilee Year. And the Australian Global March for Jesus also ended its celebrations here at Stadium Australia.
We wanted to bring the children from all over the country who'll be seeing this stadium on the television screens, and the world will, but we wanted to put them centre the story.
And the event has attracted a wide variety of Christian communities from around the world, a melting pot of the nations and Christian traditions. Amongst the sights and sounds of this modern celebration is a figure from Australia's past, Granny Smith.
We have the Granny Smith apple, and that is a lady, a native-born lady here, who found some apples at the local markets and used the top part of a barrel and threw the last half away and threw the garbage away, and eventually this apple tree was born. And the green apple, the Granny Smith, was born here in Australia. And she said this, "But isn't that like God, the stuff we chuck away? He uses to make something new and special." And we think that's our country.
So is this a one-off event, or will Christianity be evident throughout the Olympics?
Oh yes, this is a catalytic event, but all over this country there are going to be festivals and all kinds of free events where the Christian community will be moving out to invite the community and those who come from overseas to enjoy our Aussie Christian hospitality.
Worldwide, sportsmen and women are preparing for the Sydney Olympics. For many, it will be the highlight of their sporting careers.
It's very exciting to be preparing for the Olympics, more so than any other championships, I think, because there's so many countries involved and also so many sports involved, and it's really the pinnacle of any athlete's career trying to be part or being a part of such a wonderful event. I'm a Christian and I believe in God, but in my aspect of preparing for a race, I really am really thankful that I'm given this talent to be able to get out there and compete, and I want to make the most of it.
The Olympics is going to be a real time for when athletes are in the spotlight, and I guess my wishes for the Olympics are that Christian athletes will be seen by the media, will be seen by other athletes around them, to have something be different in some way, and that be because of the love that God has and the love they have for God.
I was told one day by a very influential person in my life that at the end of your life you want to be able to stand at the gates of God and be able to say you've used every bit of potential that He gave you. And so I'd like to say when I'm finished in my life that I put everything into my sport and everything into my life and that I never wasted any of the opportunities I was given.
For a lot of athletes at the Olympics, they're, you know, going to experience great highs, but others it will be, you know, great lows and career decisions and not living up to expectations and things. And it's often at times like that where athletes especially sort of start questioning the bigger questions of life and, you know, why are we here, and just looking to sort of other answers, and certainly an area where the Christian community can provide a great lot of support.
Sometimes we have to remember it's not all about winning, and even though every athlete is out there to win, but, you know, throughout my career, you know, this is my third Olympics, it's the people you meet, the experiences that you obviously experience, and I just think that it's a time where everyone's really happy. You've got countries from all around the world who are united in this one area, and it's just great to see everybody's just so happy and at peace.